According to Arrhenius, acid is a substance which dissolves in water to produce hydrogen ion.
While base is a substance which, when dissolved in water, produces hydrogen ion.
According to Brunsted and Lowry, an acid is a proton donor, while a base is a proton acceptor. Now, in your study of acid, base, and even salts, you come across weak acid, strong acid, concentrated acid, dilute acids. You begin to wonder, what is the meaning of all these things? Or, in some cases, you understand them partially. Today, I will explain them the way you understand. Concentrated acid, sometimes you see conc
H2SO4.
Before then,
you see H2SO4 aqueous.
Anytime you see a compound and subscript in bracket aq, it simply means that compound is aqueous, is dissolved in water. That is the meaning of aqueous. It's in solution. Is that okay? Now, concentrated acid is an acid in which a large amount of acid is added to small water.
Large acid, small water.
If I have, let's say, one sachet of pure water, then a big sachet of salt, and I pour it inside. So you have large amount of salt, much salt, in small water. If you test that water after it dissolves, it will cut. Ah, what is this? So too much salt, sugar in substance. That's what we call concentrated acid. So any acid can be concentrated or dilute. Dilute acid is when you add small acid to a large amount of water. So using salt as an example, the water, put little salt, you test it, you just feel it somehow. It's not concentrated, it's not that much. That is the difference between conc acid and dilute acid. Concentrated acid, large amount of acid is added to small amount of water. In dilute, small amount of acid is added to large amount of water or more water. Take note, never you add water to acid, there will be a problem, explosion, vigorous reaction. Always add acid to water, don't add water to acid. So you have water first, then you pour acid. Now, that's taken, like in the definition I gave, I said acid are substances that produce hydrogen ion or proton donor. Why base produces hydrogen ion in solution or they accept proton? Strong acid is an acid which ionizes completely in solution. It ionizes completely in solution, or in solution, it gives us the hydrogen ion. For example, if you have HCl plus water, or you say aqueous HCl, it gives you H plus plus Cl minus. Okay? So in this case, it has ionized completely in solution. All these acids, HCl, HNO3, H2SO4, HClO4, they are strong acids because they ionize completely to produce H plus. Meanwhile, weak acids, they don't ionize completely in solution. All the H plus and H3, some remains. For example, if you have CH3, COOH plus water, or let's say CH3, COOH, let's say aqueous, this will give you CH3, COOH minus. So once it dissolves in water, it gives you CH3, COO minus plus H plus. So strong acids, they dissociate readily in solution or in water, while weak acid, they don't dissociate readily. So these are the top weak acids. These are the top strong acids. You can memorize them. So I did something here. Sodium hydroxide is a weak, it's a strong base, NaOH, because when it dissolves in water, it dissociates, to, it gives you OH minus. Meanwhile, ammonia is a weak base because it doesn't dissociate completely. the salt is added to water, gives you NH4 plus and OH minus. So in summary, these are strong acid because they dissociate completely in solution. While this and this, they are weak acid. They don't dissociate completely. So it is your duty to learn them, understand them. In case you see a question, which of the following is not a strong acid? Which of the following is not a weak acid? You should know what to answer. So that is the simple logic. I am Isaac, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more amazing videos. Enjoy.